So today's topic is service sector activities in India. What are the service activities in India? For example, the entire working style has been divided into three major categories. The first one is a primary, second one is a secondary, third one is a service or the territory sector. So the people, those who depend on the agriculture, fishing, farming, come under the primary category. Those who work under the industries of either small scale or large scale come under the secondary sector. Those who are working under any of the conditions like hospitals, providing services, transport facilities, transportation industries, communication industries, software industries, all these come under the service sector. So today we are going to discuss about the focus of the service sector activities in India. So in order to understand them clearly, let us take the examples of the people, those who do the service. For example, you take Miss Sarojini, who doesn't produce rice, paddy, wheat or medicines or anything else. But she works as a doctor. She comes daily to hospital. She moves around, go to every ward, find out what are the problems of the patients and prescribe some medicines for them. And then she moves off. And when she is doing like this, she is not producing any product which is useful for them. But she is treating the people and she is making them to feel healthy, fit and fine. So here she is providing the medical services. And when we take Soundarya, she owns a grocery shop where after her children move to school, she opens it and manages till the night. And to get the products from the market, she is assisted by her husband. And here also she is not producing anything directly. She is just bringing from market and selling it to the customers who are coming to her house. She is even not going outside also. Where in the Sarojini's case, when she is a doctor, she used to move out and go to hospital. But here, Soundarya is not going to any hospital or anything. She has opened a small portion in her own house. After the children go to school, she opens the door of the shop and she runs the business. So here she is doing the commercial services. Ramesh as an accountant. So Ramesh maintains the accounts of the entire industry and he looks after the bills, checks and all these things as per the requirement and maintains a clear record of it. So Ramesh maintains the records of everything. And when we move on to Sampath, Sampath owns a minivan where he doesn't do anything except traveling on the minivan. He early morning he goes to the market. The people, those who buy the products, those who buy the fishes, they take the help of Sampath, travel in his van and move to their destinations, and Sampath makes them to reach their destination safely. So Sampath provides the transportation facilities. So here we are, neither Sarojini nor Soundarya, Ramesh or Sampath does not produce any product. They are not even doing any farming. They are not even producing any industrial product, any product which is useful for us. But they are doing the services which are useful for us to survive properly. She is providing the medical services. She is providing the items which are required for us. Ramesh maintains the records which are required for everybody to maintain in the offices. Sampath provides the transportation facilities. So these all fall under the categories of the service sector. So service sector is nothing but offering services in return of some payment. Don't misunderstand that these people are doing service out of love or passion. They are doing services for what they are paid. They can make a healthy and fine livelihood out of this. These are called specialized services where they are paid for it and they are working on it. So these kind of paid services are called as service sector. Now nowadays most of the people have started to move towards the service sector because they are paid in a handsome amount and they are having huge opportunities for these people to establish themselves. When it comes to the challenges, the major challenge what we have because of the service sector is they should be highly qualified, skilled, well educated, then only they can reach to the expectations of the customers or the consumers or the people whomever they want to work. And the importance of the service sector is the people, those who are working in the service sector, also feel, for example, they are spending, they are earning more amount of money, obviously they also will spend more amount of money in the same way. Like they spend more money for education, they spend more money for health, they spend more money for outings, they spend more money for eating out food. All these things are the challenges which are growing with the service activities in India. When we move on to the basic other changes which are happening in the day-to-days, other growth of the services. For example, if you take the business processing outsourcing units, BPOs, they provide for us the job opportunities in huge in number. When they provide the job opportunities for us, obviously, it is a company which is owned by private companies. We get the products or the projects and we provide the services for them. For example, if a person living in London wants to know about his bank accounts or these any other products, he would call to the BPO which is located in any of the cities of India and he would get the information. Further, the company would pay for the call center for the services what are offered. In this way, the employee also get paid for the calls what he receives. And then we move on to the entertainment. The entertainment channel or the entertainment issues have modern developed many things and they are making many videos or movies, which in turn has brought the development of print media, then also the electronic media to spread the news of the entertainment. And nowadays movies are the best of entertainment programs which has provided for them for the technical advancement, like directors, actors, film stars, everybody has provided the job opportunities or employment generation opportunities. These also fall under the category of the service sector. When we move on to the softwares, as you all know, many of you are dreaming of becoming software engineers. The software is a companies which provide solutions for the problems regarding the computer problems or any other issues. They maintain the database for everything and they hold the companies. They maintain a number of employees for them and they give salaries for them. In turn, they get payments for their projects. We have an example for this. A group of 4 members started a company in which they have 50 to 70 employees and their company turnover is 50 crores. 7 years before, they have started the products and they have many UK based products. So many of their friends go to UK and help them the service assistance and get back. So the software provides services, helps regarding the computer solutions and other requirements as per the consumers required for that.